So once again, good morning and welcome to this e-class of BCom 4th Sem Supplementary English. And we are discussing Playing the English Gentleman by M.J. Gandhi. It is Mahatma Gandhi, right? We have already discussed about the lesson and we will be discussing it today. We'll be discussing the remaining part of this lesson. In the earlier lesson, I told that Mahatma Gandhi, while pursuing her education in England, he was living in the city of London, that is the capital city of England, right? Then he had one good friend, in fact, but he was too much worrisome about the health of Mr. Gandhi because he was purely non-vegetarian, and most of the people of England or the Western world ate meat, right? And that's why he wanted Gandhi to be like him. He wanted Gandhi to be like the English gentleman. That's why he wanted to change the food habits of Mr. Gandhi or Mahatma Gandhi. But in fact, it was quite beyond understanding of Mahatma Gandhi why one should be, develop the taste for non-vegetarian food if he wants to be the part and parcel of one particular society. So it was quite impossible for Mahatma Gandhi, that time M.J. Gandhi, because he was just a student there, right? This Mahatma title, the father of the nation title, was conferred upon him by the people of India when he became a big figure, right? After his full participation in the struggle movement for the liberation of this country from the British Raj or British rule. So, I'll be using sometimes M.J. Gandhi this word, sometimes Mahatma Gandhi this word. Don't get confused. Okay, here Mahatma Gandhi is considered as a writer of this Playing the English Gentleman. So I read the lines and will explain you the same. But I decided that I should put him at ease. Mahatma Gandhi says, because he was taken, Mahatma Gandhi was taken to Holborn restaurant. We have already discussed about this restaurant. Keep this name in your mind because it is very examination. It is very important from the university examination point of view also. Okay, the question may be there for one line. Answer. So that Holborn restaurant, don't forget this name. So there he very politely said that no, I cannot even touch meat, M-E-A-T. Initially they were served with soup, and Gandhi wanted to inquire whether the soup was vegetarian or non-vegetarian, and when he came to know that it was non-vegetarian, he very politely said that he would go out and would search for another restaurant to have food or dinner that night. Actually, they were going to attend the court or a drama in the court, a drama in the theater, but before that they had gone to have dinner. So let's see what happened next. But I decided that I should put him at ease, and Gandhiji felt that he should somewhat maintain his relations with his friend and should not create any kind of trouble for him anymore. And that's why he did one thing. What? That I assure him that I would be clumsy no more. I won't be awkward further, right? But try to become a polished, it means sophisticated, and make up for my vegetarianism by cultivating other accomplishments which fitted one for polite society. Polite society here, this word is used for the British society or the English society, because he was living that time in the city of London, right, in England. And for this purpose, I undertook the all too impossible task. These words, I think, are very deliberately used by Mahatma Gandhi in his autobiography. This lesson is an extract. This is the part, okay, taken from his autobiography, The Experiments of Truth, right? So, and for this purpose, I undertook the all too impossible, seemingly impossible task for Gandhiji, right? Of becoming an English gentleman. So in order to assimilate in the British society, or in order to look like the British, or in order to be like the British people, he wanted to develop some other habits. Okay, it was quite impossible for him to be a non-vegetarian, right? Because he was, since his childhood, he was purely vegetarian, and that's why. Apart from that, leaving this particular thing aside, he decided to develop some other things or other habits so that he could be the part and parcel of the polite society. This word is used here. But those tasks were not easy to accomplish for this man, right? To develop a test, suddenly to develop a test for a particular thing is not easy. We are not speaking here about food, okay? To develop a test means to create an interest for some certain things, okay? Before going into depth of the following paragraph, I would like to give outline of this particular statement or this thing that he wanted to learn French. You'll come to know about all these things in the next paragraphs. Elocution, etc., violin, etc. Okay, he wanted to create in himself the interest for all these things, right? The clothes, first off, the thing that he wanted to, learn about is that the clothes or the style of wearing the clothes, okay? Because he wanted to be like the Britisher, as he was there pursuing higher education or studying the law. The clothes after the Bombay cut that I was wearing were, I thought, unsuitable for British society, and I got new ones at the Army and Navy stores. So there was this store, the name of that store was Army and Navy stores. By that time I was wearing the clothes, maybe most probably purchased from somewhat India, okay. But he wanted to change the clothes and even the style of wearing those clothes. I also went in for a top hat costing 19 shillings. All of us know, even today, they have maintained this tradition in their country, especially the British people. They generally wear what? Long hats. You will see when the Britishers come to the capital cities like Delhi or Bangalore or at the tourist places, you must have noticed that most of the people wear long hats, okay. So Gandhiji thought that would be buying the clothes from Army and Navy stores, which were basically the clothes for the British people. And secondly, he decided to purchase or he decided to buy a long hat, right. And for that he had to spend 19 shillings. It was a huge amount, especially for Gandhi or Mahatma Gandhi. An excessive price in those days. He's saying this, excessive price. Okay, it was not easily affordable for Gandhiji to buy a hat and the clothes, okay, which the British were wearing those times, or the clothes which were in fashion, especially in the British society. Not content with this. C-O-N-T-E-N-T. Here, content means happy. He was not happy with that only. He wanted to do something more. I wasted 10 pounds on the evening suit made in Bond Street. Bond Street. I have written here this particular word. It was a kind of a fashionable area, okay, in the city of London. And he went there and he had to spend. Actually, the word which is used here by M.P. Gandhi or Mahatma Gandhi is wasted. Actually spent 10 pounds on what? On evening suit, right? You know, the weather is chill or the weather is cold, and that's why most of the British, I'm not speaking here about the American people, I'm speaking about the British people, the people from Britain, that is the Englishmen. They generally wear long coats in order to protect themselves from the chill in the air or the cold in the air. The center of fashionable life in London, Bond Street. It was a famous area in the city of London, and got my good and noble-hearted brother to send me a double watch chain of gold, and requested his brother to send him, okay, what? A double watch chain of gold. It was not correct to wear a ready-made tie, and I learned the art of tying one for myself. The people who do not know how to use the tie, how to wear the tie, they buy somewhat ready-made, ties, and Gandhi also used to do that. But most of the people in Britain themselves, okay, by themselves wear the tie, and that's why he learned this art of tying one for himself. While in India, the mirror had been a luxury permitted on the days when the family barber gave me a shave. In India, when he was in India, he would use a small size mirror, okay, to see his own reflection or his image in the mirror, right? But every society has its own rules or the traditions or the customs. You'll see, if you go to the European countries, generally you find, you must have seen all these things in the movies or the films, right? Big size mirrors are there, right? So Gandhi also felt somewhere that he also should have the mirror like that, and that's why he did one thing later on. While in India, the mirror had been a luxury permitted on the days when the family barber gave me a shave. Here I wasted 10 minutes every day before a huge mirror. Now, he would be reading himself standing in front of the mirror. Okay, in order to look like, in order to wear the clothes properly, in proper way, in proper manner, so that he would be looking like the British people, right? Here I wasted 10 minutes every day. Again, the word that is used here, okay, here I spend, no, wasted, is using this word very deliberately, I think, it is my own understanding. 10 minutes every day before a huge mirror, he would stand in front of a big, a full-size mirror and would wear the clothes. So it became the routine in Gandhi's life. Watching myself, arranging my tie and parting my hair. Parting my hair means dressing, baal banana, that we call in Hindi, okay, baal banana, dressing or parting my hair in the correct fashion. Like the British people, my hair was by no means soft, and every day it meant a regular struggle with the brush to keep it in position. We nearly, most of the people in India also, we, you know, experience this thing while using combs in order to pair the hair, or you know, it in position. Each time my hat was put on and off, my hand would automatically move towards my head to adjust my hair. So this was the experience of Mahatma Gandhi when he decided, or when he tried to be like the English gentleman, right? Wearing the clothes properly, using a tie, or the wearing the tie properly, dressing his hair, etc. Next, what happened? Let's see. As if all this were not enough to make me look polished, but it was not also, it was not sufficient. Okay, wearing the clothes like the British people and tie, etc. All these things, it was not enough to for Gandhiji to look like a British man, and that's why he wanted to do something more. I directed my attention to other details that were supposed to go towards the making of an English gentleman. So he did some other things also, right? He attempted at some certain things. I was told it was necessary for me to take the lessons in dancing, French and elocution. Dancing, French and elocution. So, 1, 2 and 3. These three things, certain things, were important for a person if he wants to be like a British man or an English gentleman, to learn about all these things: French language, dancing and elocution, the art of elocution. French was not only the language of neighboring France, but it was a lingua franca. You will come to know. Lingua franca. It means a language which is used by various countries, okay, for the purpose of transaction or correspondence, right? So it was not the language of France only, it was the language which was used by so many people in that continent, European continent, right? For which I had a desire to travel, I decided to take dancing lessons at a class and paid down £3 as fees for a term. And first thing was learning French language, okay, because as it is given here in this autobiography, most of the people must be using English as well as French, okay. as a language of communication among themselves. Because you see, London is a metropolitan city, and the people from all over the world, or nearly all the corners of the world, have settled themselves there in the city of London. So you will find a kind of multicultural society there, as we have in our country also, right? So some people must be speaking French language, and it was a kind of status symbol also for so many people. And the people knew English as it was their mother tongue, but apart from that, they had the knowledge of French also. So some people, though not all the people, we cannot claim here, as it is not given here, but we can at least say that some people must be knowing this language, and they must be using this language in their daily communication, or at least among the group of elite people of British society. That's why Gandhiji tried to learn French. He joined the classes of dance also. Then what happened? But it was beyond me to achieve anything like rhythmic motion, but he could not learn dance properly. Right? He is confessing here. He is confessing here the truth of his life. He is telling the truth here. I could not follow the piano. He could not learn how to play the piano also. It means he had joined the classes to learn piano also, right? But he could not learn dancing properly, could not learn how to play the piano, etc. Language was far away. Still it was far away. Okay. I could not follow the piano, and hence found it impossible to keep time. What then was I to do? Then what? He felt his attempts or efforts to learn all these things. Piano, violin, then dancing, French language also. So what was the next plan? What was the next step in his life? Let's see. Gandhiji is saying, I thought I should learn to play the violin in order to cultivate a ear for Western music. In order to cultivate a ear, in order to create an interest for the Western music, he decided to learn the violin, right? So I invested £3 again. This time he had to pay the fees of £3 in a violin and something more in fees. Okay, he had to purchase or had to buy what? The violin. And tuition fees was of course there, which he had to pay to his music teacher. I sought a third teacher to give me lessons in locution. I paid him a preliminary fees of guinea. G-U-I-N-E-A, yeah, that is the kind of currency, right? He recommended Bell's Standard Evolutionist as a textbook, which I purchased, and I began with a speech of Pitts. Now, he joined the classes of elocution, and his teacher recommended him Mr. Bell's Standard Elocution. It is a book, okay, which Gandhi's teacher recommended him, that we should go through that particular book, so that he could learn some certain things about how to be a good elocutor, a good speaker, right? Later on, what happened? Whether he could be a good speaker, elocutionist, I am using this word, elocutionist, right, or not. Whether he failed or whether he succeeded. Let's see. Gandhi has very candidly written about all the things. He did not hide anything, he did not conceal anything, right? Very openly, very freely, very candidly has written about his successes, about his failures, about his strengths, about his weaknesses, very candidly. But Mr. Bell rang the bell of alarm in my ear, and I woke. I have not to spend a lifetime in England. And later on, he understood the fact that he won't be there in the British society until his last breath. It was clear to Gandhi after some days. He knew that he would be coming to India, he would be spending his entire life in India. He was there in England for a specific time period only, until he had to complete the degree of law or pursue higher education. For that specific period of time, he would be there, and later on he would be coming to India. It became very clear to Mahatma Gandhi, and that's why he stopped everything, all these efforts. That time he realized that he cannot be any the English gentleman. He was Indian and he would remain an Indian. He was a great man, right? But that time, what happened after all these attempts proved to be, you know, futile for Mahatma Gandhi? But Mr. Bell rang the bell of alarm in my ear and I woke. I have not spent a lifetime in England. I said to myself, he said it to himself. What then was the use of learning elocution? This question rose in his mind, right? And how could dancing make a gentleman of me? He realized this thing. How can a dance, if you learn a dance and you could be the part and parcel of a particular society? It was quite beyond understanding of Mahatma Gandhi. And then the violin I could learn even in India. He could have learned violin in India, of course, it was sure. Okay, it was very common, it was very natural. Then what happened? I was a student and ought to go. I should go on with my studies. He realized this fact at this particular point of time that I am a student, I am here to learn something and I should focus my entire attention on what I have to learn, what I have to study, for what purpose I have come here and what I am doing or I want to do. It should be very clear. Now his vision was clear, his objective was clear, his aim was clear, the end of his life was clear, the purpose of his life was clear, and that's why he realized it and says, he says, I was a student and ought to go on with my studies. I should qualify myself to join the Inns of Court. Okay, if my character made a gentleman of me, so much the better. Otherwise, I should forego, leave the ambition. I should learn the law. I should join the court. That's all. Nothing else. It was not clear to Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi. These and similar thoughts possessed me. Now, all these thoughts, you know, entered in his mind. The word possess is used here. These and similar thoughts possessed me, and I expressed them in a letter which I addressed to the elocution teacher, requesting him to excuse me from further lessons. And when he decided that he would just study the law there in England, he wrote a letter and sent it to his elocution teacher and wrote about all these things. I had taken only 2 or 3. I wrote a similar letter to the dancing teacher and went personally to the violin teacher. He wrote the letter to other teachers also and personally went to meet his teacher, who was there to teach him the violin, with a request to dispose of means sell, like the violin for any price it might fetch. And just a moment ago I told that Gandhiji had purchased the violin. He requested his violin teacher that you should sell this. Okay, and this way Mahatma Gandhi, the last 2 lines are like this. This infatuation, this passion must have lasted about 3 months. The carelessness in dress persisted, continued for years, but henceforward I became a student. So Gandhiji here confesses, you know, all these things about his own life and says that after I decided to study the law only in England, he decided to focus on the studies of law only and stop all the other things. What lesson we get from this? Playing the English gentleman. Don't imitate anyone else in your life. Be the original one. Be what you are. Show what you are and realize your own capacities, abilities, capabilities, your competency, and only then you can be the original one. You can show the people what you are. Be a big achiever. Don't imitate anyone else in your life blindly. Have faith in yourself and be a good man. Be a gentleman. Don't be like the other people. Okay, be the original one. So this is a great lesson that we learn from Mahatma Gandhi's this lesson, that is playing the English gentleman. And here the lesson ends. We stop here. Thank you.